Sukku.
Hey and namaste, guys. I was fortunate enough to take part in the inner engineering program conducted by Sadhguru Isha Foundation. And while I was there, we were served some excellent breakfast and lunch. And one of the things they gave us was the Sukku coffee, which is not really coffee. It's more like a spiced tea or spiced coffee. It only probably looks like coffee. So it has no caffeine in it. One of the things they stress in the program is not to try to avoid consuming caffeinated drinks, because when you're doing pranayama and yogic kriyas to enhance and uplift your own inner energies, the last thing you want is an artificially stimulated mind or a body. Okay, so, but to be honest, the first time I tried it, I did not like it. I was like, I'm not having this again. And I didn't until, you know, 2 weeks after, and I get this sudden urge to make Sukku coffee again. So I experimented, because I did not like it the first time around. I first of all, I referred to the guidebook. So at the program, they gave us this guidebook, and it has some basic recipes for making high pranic sattvic food. Now on page 38 of this book, there's the recipe for Sukku coffee. It says powder equal quantities of black pepper, cumin seeds, and coriander seeds with a bit of dry ginger powder, and then boil it with powdered mix. And then boil it for 5 to 10 minutes. Then strain the water, add jaggery or honey to taste, and then serve hot. So this is the original recipe, and because I've improvised it a bit and I liked it according to my taste, so I thought I'll share it with all of you. All right, so let's get started. These measurements are for a cup. I'm going to be using 3 to 4 black peppercorns, half a teaspoon of cumin seeds, half a teaspoon of coriander seeds, and 1 cardamom pod. I'm also going to be using 1/4 teaspoon of ginger powder or chai masala. You can use that. And that was the jaggery. You can also use honey as a sweetener. And I forgot, also going to be using just a touch of cinnamon powder. Now turn on the flame and add your whole spices. And roast them for 2 to 3 minutes until they turn a golden amber color and they're really fragrant. Once done, transfer them to a mortar and pestle and grind them into a powder. It doesn't have to be super fine. You can also use a grinder if using large quantities. Here I have some boiling water, which is just over a cup to account for evaporation loss. Add the ground spices and the ginger and the cinnamon and let it boil for 4 to 5 minutes. The color is going to get darker and the aroma is going to fill up your home. After about 5 minutes or so, turn off the flame and strain it into your favorite mug and add your optional sweetener of choice. And it's good to go. All right, it's ready. It's time to take a sip. Because of the fewer peppercorns that we added, there's no more burning in the throat. I like that, A+. And I can taste all the roasted spices coming through. Their oils have come up through in the water, so that's good. And it's really fragrant, and it's perfect for a winter day like this, or actually any time of the year. And you know, for all those times that you might want something decaffeinated or something not coffee or uncoffee, this might just be it. All right, I'll see you guys next time around.